不一年龄啊吧啊，我也不一年龄吧，怎么不认？
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. The Imagination of England group found that some of your thoughts of England were very accurate. On the other hand, some of them just made us laugh. They were that funny and excellent. The final group, the Rocket group, were outstanding at how enthusiastic you all were. When the rockets were flying around the place, the planes were flying, they were really, really chuffed with you all.
Okay, lastly, thank you very much for being so welcome. We felt such at home here and we're going to miss you lots.
And I'd just like to thank everyone who's taught the dancing. Today has been phenomenal. Everyone's loved it. Some of us are a little bit tired after that, but it's been brilliant. And hopefully we'll all have a good meal in a bit. So,
thanks very much.
Spent a full week with us here I'm having told us, because we run from them, in various projects which they were sharing here with us. And directors, Mr. Director, the project which has been going on this time was divided in four parts. The visitors came with a project, with four projects. Under one project, there were four projects. They had a project of impression of England and English seasons, English animals, and SAS project. And in particular, SAS project was about the rocket. And they were divided in four groups. So each group was having its own project. And the program was like this. In the 4 days they were here, they were occupying different four classrooms. In this case, the impression of England, the group of the impression of England was supposed to be senior one first, then the next day both senior two, like that. And then the English seasons repeat the same process. And then we also organized four different dances. The Zulu dance, the Chinyankore Chichika dance, and the Ntogoro, and then Chiganda dance. So the four projects, the four groups in the different projects were supposed to be learning from us the different dance styles in Uganda here, or in Africa, because Zulu is not in Uganda. And we did it successfully, as you have seen it here, and as you have heard the head boy and the head girl from Bible Community College explaining what went on in their different projects. And I thank you for that. Thank you very much. And I would also like to thank Fit for the good behavior and tactics during this visit. I have never seen that before. Because since we are supposed to be engaging them for a long time, you really did it very well, and I thank you for that. I would also like to thank the sisters from Foreign Community College, especially the students, for the good work they did. The projects were very successful, and the students really were very happy. Thank you very much. My thanks also go to the directors, the administration, and some new college. Thank you for organizing this, because without you, we wouldn't have gone a step. And most precisely, I would like to thank the headmaster, Kasomi College, and the work he did together with Mr. Brian, our new warden, and Mr. Aaron. Thank you everyone, including the teachers. And I'd also like to give the special thanks to Dave, the headmaster from Faringham Community College. When Dave came here in 2003 and visited us, his visit was good by that time, but we did not think it would go as far as this. But we thank him to be still here with us, and the 7 times or 8 you have been coming here, we really appreciate your business. And sir, you came in 2004 when you were still a student, and you are now back in 2009. We really appreciate, and we are encouraging the rest of you to also come back and visit us. And I think if we were not host even now, Sarah wouldn't have come back. I think we should clap ourselves for that kind of strength. I also recognize Dave for the things he has done to us, the financial, educational, academic, the business. For example, our students have always gone to Farringdon to see how you can try to seek a rare chance between them. And then we also thank him for sending Kasomi College beyond our borders. Because we have now 22 students from Bayern College. At least in their memories, they keep on remembering the Soviet college. They will never forget that. I mean, it's a very good achievement. And above all, I'd like to thank Dave for the unconditional love for Kasohil College. Because there are so many schools around here who have decided to look for another school. But you are really a good friend of ours, and thank you for that. And lastly, I would like to say that I, as an individual, am very happy, and I think everyone here is happy for what is going on. And because they should not go very far, we have a special lunch with our visitors, so you'll be ready for it with the reference program. And I would like to invite our best the overall winner of the speech from Kumumimje.
Master of Ceremony. Thank the Master Kasohil College. Thank the guest of honors from Farringdon Community College, my teachers, my friends, and the audience at large. Good afternoon. I am known by the name of Momini Jera, a senior 5 student doing arts as a subject. I am going to talk about climate change, which is a global issue, and how it will affect Uganda, and how it can be tackled at a global level. First of all, I begin by defining what climate is. Climate, this is the average weather condition of a place, recorded for a long period of time, usually 35 to 40 years. While weather, this is the day-to-day condition of a place, recorded for a short period of time. While some of the examples of weather we have in the world, we have the temperate, we have the savanna, we have the desert, and so this is the weather disastrous change in the variation of different weather conditions in the world. For example, you might have prolonged drought to over heavily down pozo rain. Agricultural season. In Uganda, we used to have 2 seasons where farmers plant and harvest their crops properly. And this, due to the affected agriculture from the prolonged drought and the heavily down pozo rain, this will bring famine in the country. Now again, the economy, it will hinder economic growth and development. Most of the industries in Uganda, depend on agriculture for their raw materials. Whereby, because the agriculture sector will decline, it also then decline the industrial sectors, which will lead to economic decline. So this will bring in underdevelopment in the country. I will also talk of the increased IDPs. These are the internally displaced persons or people in Uganda, whereby recently we had one in Soroti last year where people were affected by floods and they were internally displaced and needed government support to aid them. I will talk of the refugees. The affected countries will tend to search for good health or good living conditions, whereby they will come to Uganda and seek for help. Like, for example, we had one in Kenya and the recent situation in Kenya where climate change, the global warming is affecting Kenya particularly. I'll also talk of the distracted fauna and flora. Fauna and flora, these are the most attractive to the tourism attraction in Uganda. Since this fauna and flora will be distracted, it will lead to decline in the tourism sector in Uganda, leading to the increase in the national government income, which will bring in financial crisis in Uganda. I will talk of poverty. Poverty will come in due to most of the people in Uganda depend on agricultural sector for survival or where they get their activities for income. I will talk of the poor water sanitation in Uganda. The water sources will be dried out. They will be dried up from the prolonged drought, or it will be contaminated from the heavily downpours of rain, leading to poor water sanitation, where people will be left or complicated health. I'm talking of the increased rural ahead. How climate change, which is a global issue, how it can be tackled at a global level. What I will begin by saying, sensitization should be given to all everybody. How? The communication media should be established all over the world whereby people are sensitized and become aware of the climate change and how the way to fight this climate change of global warming as we talk of every day. Yeah, tree planting. Tree planting should be encouraged, a frustration. Most of the forests have been cut down to form settlement or agricultural activities. So trees should be encouraged, like for example this one. I've got one here, avocado tree plant, and this one here, we call it in my language, Garcia. It will be encouraged to be planted because they are used to some of them, the source of fruit and other protein, but of course, as you know. I'm talking about eradication of wars in a global level. This wars is where they explode these nuclear bombs, which from in the ground, raising the atmosphere, affecting the ozone layer. For example, we have one example in Pakistan. And what the recent situation which happened in Iraq, Afghanistan, our neighboring countries like Sudan, we have Somalia, which this was actually existing. So we all beg and request all the countries to come together and look for the way of eradicating these wars. I'll also talk of abolition of nuclear weapons at global level. Nuclear weapons should be eradicated, should be abolished totally. These are the nucleus which encourage most of the countries to encourage war or promote wars, which they practice this, the explosion of the bombs which rise in the atmosphere, affecting the ozone layer, bringing in what we call climate change. And talk of global financial support. All the countries will come together and raise or contribute funds to support the change for climate change, whereby we support or fund the programs like sensitization programs, we fund advertisements in radio stations, TVs, and so on. And supporting also funding the tree planting activities and also encouraging the NEMA activities by funding them and promoting them to increase and strengthen their activities. I want to also talk about signing of conventions at global level, just to unite the countries to come together and talk about this climate change, to fight for it in order to stop this issue of global warming. For example, one we had which was being talked, decided recently, but I haven't known. Global level, where the local people in the villages are encouraged, or big school for them to plant land, to be aware, to know how to read and write, listen to the news about it, and become aware of the issue when advertising or sensitizing people against climate change. I will also tell you what I mean. I mean that climate provision, all this way. So, we should not leave it rapidly again, leave it as we have provision. So, all right, don't have the time. Climate change, this is not
bringing global warming for all of the world. Senior one, Namato Jemima.
Directors, can I just, I'm only going to say a few words because my students do all my talking for me. We come to Caswell Hill College School because every year I come, you are always so welcoming. You give us such a good welcome, you make us feel at home. In fact, we feel like Ugandans. So thank you very much for that. Can I also say, as well as Caswell Hill College School being so welcoming, you have a fantastic country. We love Uganda, we love all the things that Uganda has to offer, and we just have a fantastic trip every year. So thank you for that as well. I would just like to say also a thank you to my students, all of whom were very nervous when they first came over. They weren't sure what to expect. They were very nervous about giving their lessons. I've been to see all of them in lessons working with you, and I feel very proud of them. So well done to my students. Director here. Because it's only because he talks to me continuously, we spend a long time. Thank you for that. That's all from me.
Now let me take this opportunity to invite the headmaster.
Unity College.
I'd like to invite the guests, my staff, and the entire school community. This evening I'm delighted to have you here to host you. It's been a wonderful week to have visitors from Farringdon Community College, and I think it's the cause that we are here to say farewell to them as they are going back. But I would like to thank them for the cooperation they have shown. I'd like to thank them for the innovations they have brought in Kazoi Hill College. I'd like to thank to extend my special thanks especially to Mr. Dev. So far we have 7 students sponsored by Farringdon Community College, which is great, plus some other gifts that they have given to us. I would like to extend my special thanks to our director, Ambrose, who has kept the candle lighting. That is of our relationship between Farringdon Community College and Kazoi Hill College. I think it's him who has kept that relation lighting as it is. I would like to thank my staff members for the cooperation they have shown. Especially, I would like to extend my special thanks to my, I normally call him my programmer, the DOS, who has kept things growing. With him, I think it has been very easy for us to run everything in this school, because we sit down and say, this one will run like this and we run like this, and we program it, put it on paper, and it normally runs the way we program it. But the director of studies, I would like to thank you so much. I would like to thank the entire school community for the discipline you have exhibited during the course of the week of visitors. I've not had any complaints. I'd like to thank you so much. Keep it up. Then I'd like to extend my special thanks to students from Farringdon Community College, because they've been part of us. They have done everything we've done. They have involved themselves in classwork. They have taught our students.
Once again, come over, share with us learning experiences. You may wish to not all recall that in 2002, David Wilson, director of Farringdon Community College, came over and visited us alone. And at that time, it was facilitated by the British Council, who formulated a project idea or a project proposal of developing a permanent learning partnership. Several other schools were involved in this, but today, from right information, it's only the partnership of Kazoi Hill College School and Farringdon Community College that is still running. What was the trick? The trick was the other 9 schools that were participating, the immediate requirement was a school bus, a classroom block, or they were looking at material things, not the learning partnership. When they did the first proposal, they said, we want our partner school to give us a bus. We want our partner school to do this. But for us, our approach was very humble. We said, we want to create a permanent learning partnership. Let our students in the Kazoi Hill College School have permanent friends in Farringdon Community College School. Let our teachers in the Kazoi Hill College School have permanent friends in Farringdon. Let the directors of Kazoi Hill College School have permanent friends in Farringdon. And that was the approach. And today, even though I'm not able to come here quite often, you know, I just come here like maybe once in a while, but this is up and running. and the quality is not mine, but each and every one in this school and environment that has kept this money. I want to thank BFID, that's the Department for International Partnership and Development of the UK, and the British Council, who initiated this from the very beginning by facilitating the initial visits of the teachers from Paddington and also the visits of the teachers from Catholic College School to go over to UK. And within that, they were able to guide us on how we should formulate our objectives in order to enhance sustainability for this project. And for the British Council, the ideas of the cultural involvement, the ideas of scientific involvement and learning together have blended well in this partnership of ours. Over the last 7 years, the projects have worked together, starting from renewable energy, food security, tourism. I remember Sarah tracking the gorillas in Mbehinga, and one of us pushing the midline, not being able to go up. So the tourism projects that we worked on, the solar batteries that we have brought here, the art and design, the music lessons we have posted from the teachers in parallel with the college, have enriched not only the knowledge and skills of our students, but also the culture, and developed ourselves as global citizenship. You may ask yourself, that why should we learn about our English weather? I have a personal experience where I missed the flight because where I was, the clocks changed. They were changed from winter and from one side to another. And because of that, it was collapsing an hour. Instead of being ahead by 3 hours, we are now ahead by 2 hours. So I thought I still had 1 hour to go. But because the weather changed, the hours are also changed and I missed the flight. So if you can know now that the global weather, about that knowledge will be good for you in the future as students. So pick an interest in whatever you learn from these colleagues of ours. And also, our Paddington Community College friends, I appreciate what you have been able to learn in just a few days since the 1st of November when we came here. You've been able to pick up the dances of the Chiganda or the Chikina, things like that. I really appreciate that. So finally, I want to thank you, Dev, for the efforts you have come on the communication channels. And for the cooperation back home to find the community college, it's really appreciated when you go here the 1,000 people to school, appreciate the learning, partnership. And our emphasis will always remain developing permanent learning partners. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
we also have another one from Faith School that we also call this other course and find by you the students. That's what we school. Of course, you are learning partners, but all of them should come, so you are the ones who decide how it should be. Thank you.
Thank you. We've all left it, my students and myself.
I want to put it down.
So this one did not, well, was not in the photograph. This is a parent.
Who missed, but the
teacher was the one who was in program. Now he's having the family and he wants to be in the photograph with the rest. You can stand in the background.
Castle Hill School.
Yes. That's nice. Good.
Yeah. Is this a good? Thank you. Now, you can now put, they can put food, the whatever, yeah. The soup in here.
Yeah.
Just a very little.
Oh, thank you.
That's good.
What is this?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Enjoy the meal.
Yeah, thank you so much.
And a piece of popcorn. This is fruit. They're fruits.
Thank you.
So it's not, you don't need to eat it. Pineapple or whatever, but it's not. Try it, jackfruit. You must try it. And popcorn.
What's the taste like? Popo. Oh. Thank you.
Popo.
Oh. Oh, yes, babe. Oh, just a second, please. Oh, all right, I'll just come back. Which one?
In a bit. Thank you very much. Oh, wait. Thank you. Hi, Praise.
Yeah.
Okay,
right.
Try something different.
Okay.
Thank
Thank you.
빠지 거라지 우리.
Yeah.